Well, SANDAG Executive Director Hasan Ikhrata explained why he is still standing by a plan that would charge drivers for every mile they drive, even after his board abandoned it, and further detailed whether he thinks it's time for him to leave his job. Joining us now to discuss this is SANDAG board member and mayor of Coronado, Richard Bailey. Good morning to you, Mayor. Good to see you.
Good morning. Great to see you as well.
So this is something you and I have discussed in previous interviews, but despite actually members of SANDAG listening to their constituents and deciding, okay, we've heard loud and clear, San Diegans don't want to pay per mile for what they drive, Director Hasan Ikhrata has really stood by it and said this is what San Diego needs. How is that sitting with board members, and who's now going to take action, I guess, and make him stand up for what San Diegans have said they wanted?
Yeah, these comments were a bit surprising to me because it demonstrates just how out of touch Mr. Ikhrata is with the 98% of commuters that are looking just to get to and from work, to and from visiting with friends and family quickly, safely, and economically. But even more important than that is that it demonstrates a fundamental misunderstanding of the role of the board and his role as an executive officer. When you have a board that is nearly unanimous in wanting to remove the road usage charge from this regional transportation plan, and then you have Mr. Ikhrata essentially rooting for the state of California to deny our plan unless that road usage charge is included, it makes you wonder, is the executive director faithfully carrying out his responsibilities and the direction of the board?
Now, in that same article, Hasan Ikhrata has said that this will reveal whether or not the state is serious about its pledge to combat climate change. I mean, that's why you're talking about him making a bet on whether or not the state's going to root for this plan. But where is the oversight for the role and job that he's doing? Do we have any?
Yeah, the oversight should, if we have a functional agency, the oversight should be resided with the board of directors. And the board of directors, to their credit, back after they originally passed this plan in December of last year, to the board's credit, they did hear from the constituents, and the constituents told us to get rid of the road usage charge. And the board responded to their constituents' requests by removing the road usage charge from the plan. Unfortunately, it appears as though Mr. Ikhrata has been undermining board direction, as he initially failed to even notify the state of California of the board's intentions to remove the road usage charge. And now essentially he appears to be rooting against the board direction to be approved by the state of California. So I think it is, you know, past time for the board to get serious about making sure that Mr. Ikhrata actually follows the board direction or looks for other employment.
Well, can the board of directors call for his resignation or remove him from his role? Is that what could be coming?
The board of directors certainly could do that. The board of directors is the body that hires our executive director. But I want to remind viewers just for a second what Mr. Ikhrata's own standards were for his success. He has previously said that if the regional transportation plan fails either to get board approval or fails to be accepted by the voters, that it would be time for him to leave. And when you look at what happened with this regional transportation plan, a huge funding source, the road usage charge, has already been removed from the plan by the board of directors. And another large funding source, the first of three sales tax increases that was scheduled to go in effect in January of 2023, failed to even make the ballot this most recent election cycle. So by all accounts, this plan is already unraveling. This plan is already a failure. And I think we should look to Mr. Ikhrata's own standards for judging whether or not he's been successful. And I think you would arrive at the conclusion that he has not.
Well, we'll see how he listens to his own standards following this. And, you know, real quickly before we have to go, Mayor, what about the balance of power on the board? Would that perhaps affect his decision to leave or stay?
It potentially could. I think you have several new board members that will be joining SANDAG. These board members are appointed by the respective city councils, so there are still a few city councils left to appoint their representative to the SANDAG mm-hmm. board. So we'll see what the final balance of power looks like in the coming weeks.
All right. Mayor Richard Bailey, thanks so much. We'll stay updated on this road usage charge being in there. Appreciate it.
Thank you.